What is up, everyone? My name is Michael Pohl with Bay Area Aquatics, and today I'm going to talk to you about how to use a spawning mop and how to get the eggs from the spawning mop to where you want to hatch out the fry. All right, so this is a pretty simple kind of update, I guess, on my spawning mop video. I did a video a while back on how to make them because I was planning on spawning some egg scattering fish and I wanted to be able to pull the eggs out, and I've been able to do that. And I had a lot of people leave comments in that video as well as other videos on, okay, you made the spawning mop, but how do we use the spawning mop? How do you get the eggs from the mop into something else? How do you move the mop? What do you do? And I didn't think about that. I didn't think that far ahead as far as like the setup of the video. So I'm gonna go ahead and talk about that a little bit today. And there's a couple of options that you have for spawning mops and kind of using. Now the first one, and this is kind of the easiest one in my opinion, would be you would pull the spawning mop out of the tank, and as you're pulling it up, you kind of squeeze it so you, the water gets out, so it's not like a super wet, drippy thing. And you just move the spawning mop to a new tank, whether that be a 5 gallon bucket, whether that be a whole nother tank, whether it be your fry system, however you do it, you just pick the entire spawning mop up, drop it in another tank, let the eggs hatch out, and call that good. Now, I'm very, very, very limited on tank space, so I use breeding boxes. I use the Marina hang-on back breeding boxes. I like them. I think they're kind of the best case scenario for me. I know not everyone's a fan of them, but they have their issues. But like I said, for me, that's what works the best. And what I do is I actually pull it out of the water, squeeze all the water out, just like I said before. And then I go through and I hand pick all the eggs out of the spawning mop. And I drop them into a little ball of Java moss on a hang-on back field or a hang-on back breeder. And that's the way that I transfer eggs, and then I'm able to kind of watch the eggs because they're close. I can see them. I can see if any of them are fungusing or anything like that. And I can see when they start to hatch, and I can kind of watch them develop. And it's really cool, especially with my rice fish. You're able to kind of see the eyes develop in them and the different stages, and then you see them hatch, and you go, okay, now they're actual fry. Versus in a big like 10 gallon tank or even a 5 gallon tank, they're going to be kind of covered up in the spawning mob, and it's a lot harder to kind of find the fry because it's a bigger thing. Versus this, you can kind of, it's a little tiny thing and you can see everything a little easier. But that's how I do it. Like I said, real simple. I've seen some people say they use like tweezers and stuff. I just use my fingers just because I think that the tweezers might be a little too rough. That's just kind of in my head. All the fish eggs that I've worked with have been fairly sticky. So a lot of times I don't even need to pinch them. I just kind of put my finger on them and it sticks to my finger. And then I can just kind of shake my finger in the water and it drops off. So it's pretty easy. It's not super hard to do. But yeah, that's how you use a spawning mop. So let me know how you pick the eggs out of the spawning mop. If you use tweezers or your fingers or whatever else, do you move one over to the tank? Do you put it in a breeder box? I'm looking to kind of play with some short ones, because I use those breeder boxes attached to 10 gallons. So I might make some spawning mops that are only like 3 or 4 inches tall that float so that I can move the spawning mop from the tank just straight into the breeder box. But I'm not sure if the fish will do that. And right now I'm focusing a little more on production, but that's something I want to play with here in the future. So let me know if you've done that, because that's something that came across my mind the other day. And I'm really interested on trying that. So if you're new here, be sure to hit the subscribe button so you can see every time I upload a video. If you want to get notified every time I upload a video, hit the bell notification and you'll get notified. If you liked the video, give it a thumbs up. If you didn't, you know what to do. As always, thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys next time.